I've been in the insurance business for over 15 years. Some of it restoration work, some is adjuster, and some of it is working with FEMA and inspecting large commercial buildings for underwriters. I have uncles that are roofers, I have cousins that are roofers, and my father is a brick mason. It's quite fulfilling because of the fact you get the opportunity to help people. You're going after hurricanes, tornadoes, earthquakes, and you arrive on the scene to help them to get back on their feet. You're able to save the insurance company money and keep the residents in their homes or get them back in their homes sooner. Anytime you get on a ladder, there's always a possibility the ladder could slide up from you and cause you serious injury. I had an incident probably about 10 years ago or something when I was on a roof. I was up right near the gable, the ridge. The scaffolding kicked out from underneath us, and we fell about 32 feet. Falling off a scaffold or a ladder is pretty much it's like a dream. Almost like when you're falling off a cliff. You don't see the bottom coming, or you do see the bottom coming. But in my case, I saw the bottom coming closer and closer, and when I hit it so hard, I bounced. A good buddy of mine, he damaged both of his knees because he fell through the ladder. He still walks with a limp, and now he mostly does mechanic work. You take shortcuts sometimes to speed up the process and actually make more money. We both made the decision. But I feel kind of responsible sometimes because of the fact that I didn't really get hurt.
Hello.
Hello, Jay.
Yes.
Hey,
yes.
Thomas.
How you doing, Thomas? Nice house you have.
We found a leak in the pantry, which is on the roof.
Okay. Well, it's amazing. I mean, that I didn't have to get on the roof to see this. But there you go, it's been patched before. So that's where your leak is. See, this is a benefit.
This is a residence with a terracotta roof. It's very difficult to climb because it breaks very easily.
In the normal inspection process, someone would go up there and climb, and he'd probably do more damage to the roof than what was there originally. If you break one, you're gonna break about five each step you take. I could do every house on this corner. It took 5 minutes to fly the drone for something that would have taken me an hour to inspect on my feet, and it's more complete. That looks good. This guy is rusting from the inside, and there's a small crack. It looks like it goes actually outside of the gutter can. So that's gonna need to be replaced. That's a second chimney, huh?
Right now, we're at the Carver, which is a famous old theater in New Orleans, and now it's just recently been renovated.
The challenge for large commercial inspections, you don't want to have a lot of business interruption. When they are interrupted and they start losing money because of me, then they look at you in a different way, that you're just wasting my time. We saw it today, they didn't hardly know we were there. We did complete infrared and photo inspections. And maybe one or two people came out and knew that what we was doing. If I had a drone, I wouldn't need a ladder. I definitely wouldn't need the use of measuring tools. I wouldn't need a roller wheel. I wouldn't need tape measure. That's great. 10 years ago, a drone would have saved me a lot of trouble. I probably would have fell off the ladder. When Katrina hit, you had strong winds, you had flooding, and you had mold. I worked several different establishments like a Saks Fifth Avenue, a Wyndham Hotel, the Ritz-Carlton. This is roof damage from Katrina. You have to understand they had like 15 feet of water some places, a lot of tragedy. Well, it gets to be about any storm, I think, just to see people displaced. It's tragic because they feel helpless. Many times they lost pretty much everything. I feel empowered anytime I could help someone. And what I'm able to do is give them a little piece of it back.